do pretty well with it. Dark Gentleman's pretty strong with it. He did not beat KaZ, but you know there was the character switch involved.
Uh-huh.
But he did take out Mies, who was on a Mies the Beast, who was on a pretty good run in our in that pool. But yeah, JimmyJoe just opting for the old Pika Ditto. Again, when you think you're, you know, more experienced than someone, you think you have a little bit of an edge in them.
Yeah, you know, you just remove some variables. You know, you play the same character. I mean, and JimmyJoe knows this matchup well. You know, this is something that he'll play a lot. It's a lot of different players, and so he'll know what to do. And of course, you know, the Pika Pika matchup has been analyzed probably more than any other matchup in the game. In terms of what to do at different percents, you know, how to edge guard or how to follow up with combos as much as possible.
I think there's a surprising amount people don't know. Mm-hmm. Most players, even at the top, don't quite understand edge guarding and whatnot. But yeah, there's more information and video on this matchup than probably any. There's a lot of Pika Falcon too. But
that is true.
I don't know if it quite matches the Ditto. KaZ bopping his head, getting the first stock, rocking that Pika hat.
And both of them liking that, you know, Pikachu's get-up attack. Actually, it was really good. You know, it's really easy to underestimate it.
At the
just
ledge?
A get-up attack. You know, what's the big deal? Oh, at the ledge. Yeah, ledge get-up.
It's really strong.
It hits them way far away that, you know, that you're sort of resetting after a get-up attack or a ledge attack hit.
That was one of the old-school, like, edge guard options was you do the get-up attack, and it knocks them backwards, and they're in a perfect spot for you to cover all their options. You don't see it as much anymore, but it's still very strong. You're invincible during it, so. Oh, well.
Just hanging out for a little bit. JimmyJoe, very adept user of the forward tilt. But
see that you can't. Can't bank on the F smash there. There are a lot of options you have. Oh, that was just a crazy exchange. He got
really
him
was.
With the neutral B.
He did.
KaZ
tries to go for the jab grab, I think, but realized he was in front.
Yeah, he missed a little spacing there.
Oh, it's catching him with the. One thing I'll tell JimmyJoe a lot in this matchup is I think he underuses up air as approach. It's a really good way to you know, bridge the gap. Good
up air is probably the toughest move to utilize as an approach for Pika. Like, sweeping down air is pretty well documented, very simple. Back air, it's pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
But, like, the way up air comes out in front of you late makes it pretty difficult.
But if you get the timing right and you get that sort of
it's
horizontal up air, then
it's very underrated because everyone knows it's a very strong move, but in that situation
it's also the hardest move to do. You know, like, you never want to flub a tech, but you know, doing an up air, you know, making sure you're not jumping again, of course, is always something you might have on your mind.
Quick movement from JimmyJoe, following him off the side plot with a fast fall nair. That's
good pressure here.
Difficult. Yeah, KaZ started off strong, but you know, JimmyJoe took the lead. He's not that far ahead, but if he can just hold on to the stock as long as possible,
get some more percent.
Ditto, you know.
Ooh, I think he could have grabbed there. Gets the blue. gets the electricity. So yeah, he's smiling.
There are a lot of things JimmyJoe could have done to get out of that.
Could have,
But I'll say probably up B would have been.
Up B probably the easiest.
Ooh. And here we're sitting at 43%.
That's a little overreach there by KaZ, jumping up with that back air.
Oh, the get-up attack set him up. Oh, yeah, that was not a good ledge get-up option for KaZ in that situation.
Keeps the edge guard going. Oh, it doesn't? Yeah, I think that was the right move. I'm not sure if he got the grab, but classic Pika multi-grab.
You can't let Pika up be into the middle of the stage like that without getting a punish. It's just, there's enough landing lag. Oh, the dash attack!
Dash attack.
Right. this matchup feels like it's shifting more and more into Kaz's favor.
Yeah, but he's slowing it down a bit.
That's all JimmyJoe needed.
Yeah.
Catch him on the side putt, get a jab grab.
Yeah. And I think what made the difference, at least at the very end there, you see that Kaz's pressure when JimmyJoe's in his shield on the platform versus JimmyJoe.
Yeah.
You know, Kaz was doing aerials, but then eventually the pressure just wears off. JimmyJoe knows it's one of the best ways to get to Pikachu when he's standing in shield like that is to
jab
come with a forward air and then right into a jab grab. And that's what he's able to do.
He's been using a lot of the down air into the jab grab.
Yeah, that works well as well.
I like the stronger hits rather than the forward air. The forward air is shield pressure is very weak, so it's very tight.
Precise timing.
I like the reverse back air because then you're facing him. It's got the most,
so it's an easy grab. Yeah,
it's basically guaranteed unless you just completely screw up.
But yeah, I mean, besides grabbing, you definitely would know this better than me. But if Pikachu's shielding on a platform, can you even? You definitely can't. I don't think you can get any guaranteed punishes unless you do a grab.
If you're coming from under, sometimes it's good to like hit him with an aerial coming up, and then wait for them to drop out of shield.
I see, and then
fall
on the way down
there.
Yeah.
That's not like a true punish like jab grab is. But if they are not ready to shield drop or protect themselves with the proper
or
aerial,
up B, right?
Yeah. If you time it right, it's very hard for them to avoid getting the nair plopped on their head.
Oh, JimmyJoe should have been able to get another grab there.
What happened? It's been a minute, and JimmyJoe's lost two stocks.
Yeah, we've been talking about some tech, and next thing we know.
I know he had an SD, but I feel like he had some percentage on. So, got Kaz off stage. Oh, Kaz put himself right there. One tactic I've seen work lately is kind of like, you know, 2015 meta, where you would jump out at someone if a Pika's recovering close to the stage. You jump out as they phase out into up B, and you just land an aerial on them. Because when they come out of the phase,
they're
just get hit.
Yep. Yeah. It's definitely, you know, if you're a Pika player or you play against a lot of Pikas, it's worth taking the time and seeing what the hitbox looks like when he's doing his up B, because the hurtbox, because he's not invincible the entire time, you know, and just opportunities to hit.
As Shears likes to say, risk-free edgeguard.
Yeah.
If you go out there and throw something out, there's nothing that Pika can do to hurt you, and Kaz.
I think he's maybe trying to be a little flashy there. Not necessary. F smash, I think, would have been fine. But now, look at this. He's getting punished for it.
Yeah, and I know he had a pretty strong lead. He didn't know what to do.
He didn't know what to do. He's got a grab, right?
Yeah.
He still gets the kill.
Grab at any percentage, any direction, or any direction there works at that percentage.
Really?
He's at like 150.
Okay, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
I misread the percentages. JimmyJoe only down a stock. I mean, he's been playing well, all things considered.
Kaz is baiting JimmyJoe into these ledge hops onto the stage and just up tilting him. You'll see a lot of players overextend. They think they can jump up over the ledge and get like a nair or an up air arm. But that doesn't work anymore. You have to be prepared to get up smashed or up tilted out of it.
That's def.
And Kaz fires back in game two with a pretty convincing two stock, even after going for that down B and not getting it. I do respect it, but you're playing. You can't try and don't try and gimmick a guy that's seated above you, that's got more experience. If you're good enough to pull off the upset, you got to play lockdown the entire time.
It's true.
Don't give them any openings if they aren't already there.
All right, game three. I think both players have the potential really to do well. It's just will come down to.
Seen a lot of back and forth sets today where somebody won game one convincingly, somebody won game two convincingly, and then game three came down to like last stop.
Yeah, down to the wire.
Kaz putting on
good
serious
here.
Pressure.
That up tilt is going to be tough for JimmyJoe here.
That up tilt went so high, I'm surprised that they caught him. Yeah, when Pika's that far out, you can't let him recover that easily.
Yeah.
That was just a poorly spaced aerial. He just landed it right in front of him.
Oh, interesting.
I don't know. The the down smash.
Nice edge cancel there.
All right. KaZ taking advantage. Taunting. Taking advantage of a poorly spaced aerial from JimmyJoe, just up smashing him out of it. Very rare that you have such an opportunity present itself to you to up smash like that. Take a stock.
KaZ, you're definitely controlling the match. You know, he's getting JimmyJoe a lot with up tilts when JimmyJoe's coming in. I think he's being JimmyJoe's being a bit more aggressive than he has to be.
Oh, yeah, and earlier, you know, we were talking after JimmyJoe beat Cheers, and we were saying, you know, I was at least saying, like, that's a pretty solid argument for D1 at this point. You know, if Cheers is easily the toughest in his pool, handled KaZ, but KaZ, obviously not, you know, letting that loss get to him too much.
No, not at all.
Giving JimmyJoe a very good fight.
All right, this is a pivotal moment right here. If JimmyJoe can survive at least a little bit, get some percents.
KaZ is going to be fishing for that grab.
Yeah, for sure. Ooh, all right, he gets opened up.
JimmyJoe kind of pressed a bit of an spacing advantage there. Put himself in possible danger. But
oh, nice fall through the platform.
KaZ isn't ready to protect himself from all of JimmyJoe's aerial approaches yet. Involves very... good knowledge of the timing of up air.
Ooh, nice up tilt.
Forward tilt here? All right. JimmyJoe.
Oh, it's too far. Yeah, I think he just got another back air. But that'll do it, too. And now JimmyJoe ties it up.
Wow. Yeah. Two stocks apiece. It's crazy.
Oh, JimmyJoe. He gets like skid. The weird skid, yeah.
And he's just letting KaZ
there
drop
we go.
Aerials
yeah, drop right into the up tilt.
Oh,
no, that's rough. Hopefully he gets his edge guard here. Yeah, I mean, I guess as a Pika player, what do you do in the situations? F smash or you just drop down in nair?
If you're going to grab the ledge like that, you just down air.
Yeah,
down air has
a lot
of vertical coverage.
JimmyJoe up a clean stock here. Hopefully he doesn't let it get to his head.
Yeah,
throwing out that taunt.
We haven't really seen somebody take command yet, so I have to believe that KaZ is going to fire right back.
Yeah.
A little too slow to punish the top there.
Good. Sometimes you got to be bold and run in with a grab. I mean, especially when you know the other players are playing very cautious.
KaZ knew exactly where JimmyJoe was going. Kind of telegraphed, but he was a little late. And again, yeah,
KaZ is pulling out those high recoveries.
He's just a little late.
Yeah.
Interesting to see him go with down air.
Ooh, he's coming down with that down air. JimmyJoe, good job of getting around it and gets control of center stage. Loves trying to throw out those F tilts.
See, that time KaZ landed. Ooh, it's going to be rough. KaZ landed an aerial in front of JimmyJoe, but this time he followed it with an instant up air. With
the nice jab direction. Grab. The jab grab saved
and
the day.
JimmyJoe clutches it out
yeah,
at
wow.
the end there.
That
really
was a good performance by JimmyJoe. I think he kept his cool, you know, showing why. He's still someone you can't sleep on.